Yes. Thank you. Okay, welcome to this talk. We're going to talk about the MySQL Sandbox, which is a tool to install MySQL easily. How many of you know MySQL Sandbox already? Good. Thanks. So what is it? It's not an official MySQL product. It's a piece of software under GPL. It's something that installs a tarball or MySQL server in a few seconds. And it's specifically designed to install servers for testing. Not the main one, because the main one is easy to install. You just download the thing that could be in your server. .deb, .rpm, or just use your Linux command and you have the main installation ready. Also the upgrade is fine. But if you need more than one version, or if you need more than one server, this is the problem. So I start scratch on my own edge and to install many servers for testing because I was a UA developer. Even before that, I was a consultant, so I need to install several servers because every one of my customers have a different version. So I need to install this version to test what was wrong. And I have to do this manually. I can go through the motions of installing something MySQL server manually, you know the problem. But anyway, this tool was created because I had a problem and I was lazy to do this manually. So I ended up doing a lot more with the tool to make the tool instead of doing my main job. This is a different story. System requirements. It works mostly everywhere if that everywhere looks like Unix. Doesn't work on Windows, sorry. I don't know Windows, but eventually. This sandbox is really fast. This presentation is going to last a little more than a few seconds that you need to use the sandbox. Because this is like boxing. In sandbox, like in boxing, you have to prepare a lot. And then you have to deliver a punch in 1 second. So let's go to the training first, and then we can have a punch. What's the problem in installing MySQL Server in modern ones? you start believing me, eventually. I didn't want, once I installed the sandbox, I didn't want to use a long MySQL command to use it and to start it. So there is a separate instance of server. How do I use it? I need to say, use this data directory, this port, this socket, and so on. Long to remember, and it makes mistakes. So the sandbox also creates some scripts. You will find where you use new inside the sandbox itself. You want to start, and you say start. Stop, start, clear, and then use to actually use it. Now, a single sandbox is useful, but there are multiple sandboxes that are even better. Lord of the Rings, you know Lord of the Rings, one ring to rule them all, one sandbox to rule them all. So I made multiple sandboxes that are contained inside the sandbox. And for this, I start all, stop all, clear all, and everything. If you have replication, I have one M that stands for master, S1, first slave, S2, second slave, and so on. How does it work? First of all, you need to install the sandbox. The easy way of doing that is root, just to install MySQL sandbox inside CPAN. CPAN is a tool for Perl modules. That's it. This is, once you have this, the sandbox is installed and you can use it. If you want to install it as an unprivileged user, I am not going to explain it to you today, but you can do it in the manual. You can do that and install without a root password. But let's see how the sandbox works in practice. So we have a tumble and we want to install it. We just say make sandbox and the name of the tumble. And that's the end of it. After that, you have a server installed and ready to use. We want replication, same simplicity. Make replication sandbox and then the tumble. And you have one master and two slaves of mine. And you can decide to have more if you want. Circular replication. Who knows what circular replication is? Have you tried it to install? Was it easy? Yeah. So circular replication is probably after cluster the most difficult thing to install in MySQL. It's guaranteed that you make mistakes doing that. And it's guaranteed that when you finish making mistakes, there are even mistakes you didn't find when you were installing. So you will have to curse 7 days before you have something that works fine. If you need to test something using a circular replication, I can tell some boxes does that in a few seconds. You just have to say circular and how many nodes you want to create. Or sometimes you need to have several servers not in replication, and you say just multiple sandbox. And this command will create a sandbox containing three servers. If you need more, you just add it. Again, we come back to the problem of being lazy. If you install the several versions several times, it might be easy instead of saying the name of the tarball, saying only the version you want to install. So if you expand all the tarballs that you want to work with inside the one directory, then you can just say make sandbox version. sandbox can use them. So if you say my file equals small, it will not only create a simple server, but it will take the parameters from the my small file and insert a new sandbox option file. If you don't remember all the options, it's easy because there are something like four of them. You can say interactive. Things that work on everyone using a MySQL database being designed send a call for, that will execute the same command for all the sandboxes. And at the end, we have a use all, which is very handy because it sends the same command to all the nodes inside the server. Inside the application, you have M for the master, S1, S2, S3 for the slaves. Where you have a multi-node sandbox is the same as for replication. And if you have a multi-node sandbox that is not in standard replication, so you can call the nodes with N1, N2, N3. Everything clear so far? Now, it gets better. I tell you that there are single sandboxes and multiple sandboxes. And the multiple sandboxes are sort of a lot of ring command, but all the sandboxes inside belong to one single sandbox command. However, if you play sandboxes a lot, you may find that they are too many for you to keep track of them. If you are like me, that you can start like 20 sandboxes at once, then you want to remove them. You don't want to go inside each sandbox and say stop. You want to do everything at once. So you have a master sandbox for everything. By default, this sandbox home is your home with the directory called sandboxes. And inside that, you will find a start all, stop all, and clear all commands that are very handy if you want to stop everything at once. Or if you are testing several directories, this use all SQL statement will make you even lazier than me. So you can create sandbox with a lot of servers. All the same version. You can have sandbox standalone, sandbox in replication, and Google independent sandboxes. Or you can have a mix of sandboxes of different versions. You can have several versions with several configurations. And the important thing is that all of them are independent. They don't clash each other. Of course, you need to have some RAM and some CPU power. This was the theory. Now, let's see some practice. If you want to install a sandbox, you do make sandbox and the name of the tarball, or if you have done the sandbox binary, as I explained before, you can just say the version name. The important thing that I want you to see is that at the end of all the installation, it tells you where it has installed the sandbox. By default, it's MSB, MySQL Sandbox, and the version number. But you can change this. So to use the sandbox, you go to the directory that was told to you and say use. And you have a special prompt created by the sandbox that tells you this is MySQL. The host, the user, and the database that you are using at the moment. When you do application, it works the same way, only it installs more servers, and then it tells you which directory is used. How to use it? It doesn't go to the directory that was told to you in the previous screen, and use M for master. command to all the nodes and get the result from each node. Use all is going to be very handy. Now, let's make some tests. So, as a 2A person, you want to see how the application behaves in some places. In this case, I'm going to break the application on purpose. How do I do it? First, with the master, let me use a pointer for this. With the master, I create one table. Then, in the first layer, I will insert one value. Then I insert again the same value in the master. Now, if you know how replication works, I take replication here because when slave 1 tries to replicate the command from the master, it finds that the record is already there. So now, if I do check slaves, the slave 1 says that slave SQL is not running. And if I want to know where the problem is, I do like this. S1 shows slave status, that last error. And this is the last error, duplicate K. So in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the command line commands, I can see what is the problem. Single replication, if I want to create a single replication, the only thing that I have to do is say circular, because how many nodes you want to create. How does it work? In this example, using node number 1, I create a table. Using node number 3, I insert something. And then I ask everybody to answer the question. And you can see that everybody has the same command. So this is a circular replication that is working fine because I create something with one node and everybody has it. Then I insert it using a different node and again everybody has it. Now, circular replication can break for different reasons, but this is beyond the scope of this discussion. This just tells you that SQL replication can be installed in Sandbox and works fine. If you want to improve a condition or change the condition for testing, you can do it easily with Sandbox using the start and stop. For instance, in this case, we have a key buffer size of 1.8 megabytes. We want to change it to 20 megabytes. You just do this, but key buffer equals 20 M. And then show variables, and you see we have 20 megabytes. Very handy. You can have different conditions for testing in an easy command. Using the same principles, you can create several directories, several sandboxes, and use start all or restart all to change the conditions. I use it I've used the sandbox for testing partition and unpartitioned tables. And it's very easy to do that. You just create a group directory called partition and group directory called unpartition. Assign different port numbers, and then you have if start, do the test, and stop. So if you want to do this with the normal servers without the sandbox, you have to do everything manually. The sandbox makes it easy for you to do one click like this that will take you to the test, the real work of the test in seconds instead of spending more time deciding how to change the server. You just use the sandbox architecture to run the server directly. The sandbox is good and it's great, but I keep using it, and then I keep doing more things with it, because the more I use it, the more I want to be lazy and improve it. So, version 3.0 was released a few months ago, and what we have now, instead of needing a separate installation, this is a pair package, so you can just say zip and install and does. I added a new tool that is called SD tool, sandbox tool, that does a couple of new things. You can detect the ports, so you can tell the sandbox install something just in a way that doesn't compete with other ports. It does. You can install from source directory. You can create a test suite, and there is more documentation. Port detection is very handy. So you want to install several sandboxes of the same version. You do like this, make sandbox 5133, check port. So it will be the first time 5133, and this is the name of the directory. If you do it once more, instead of giving you an error that you get if you don't do check port, it will find that 5134 is not used and create a 5133A. And if you do it once more, it will use 5135 and create 5133B and so on. So you don't have to remember what did I install, which versions I'm using. Say, just do it, and it does. For the people who are working with the source code, they want also to use the sandbox from the source directory. So, means that you have compiled MySQL and you want to use the sandbox from things that you have already compiled. So there is one stick that is called make sandbox from source. And it works. The SB tool, now it does a lot of different things. Servercon is something that just copies the content of one sandbox to another, or you can move one sandbox to a different place. You can change the port, you can delete sandboxes, you can make a list of the port used, you can find the port range that is useful if you want to store a group of sandboxes, and you can do multi-level replication. So cloning is easy. You just want to take the data that you already installed in one sandbox. You don't want to run a million queries to recreate that. You just use the SB tool that will clone sandbox to another. Moving sandbox is when you don't want the sandbox to be in that place. You want to use a different directory for whichever reason. And it does that. And it changes all the references in the space. Test test script. In this case, you can check a single cell. So first of all, you say make a sandbox. You say what you expect to see. So you are telling the test environment that as a result of this command, this should be part of the output. And this is the message that you want to see when the test runs. The test environment will run this command if this doesn't show up. It will tell you that this is a mistake and we stop. Then you want to run an SQL command to this sandbox. So this is the sandbox that you want to run the command with. This is the query. This is what you expect. So you expect to see 530 in answer to the query select version. And this is the message that we will put. Using this infrastructure, you can do very complex testing. I'll explain to you everything. This is part of the test. At the end, you can stop the sandbox. So when you run the test, it will do like this. Okay, number one, sandbox creation. Okay, number two, check version. Okay, number three, stop. Execute the three test, pass 300%. And you can make the test to embed this into more complex test suites that understand the DAP of this test answer protocol. And I'm not going to bore you with this, but it's something that you can really insert in different cases. Okay, this was what I said before. One more thing that I added in version 3, you can create a hierarchical replication. I don't know if you know about this. Every slave can also become a master. So if you have one master, then one slaves, and each one of these slaves is master of two or three more slaves. This is a tree replication. Using the sandbox, you can do this with a man. After SQL replication, this is the most difficult thing you can do with the SQL replication. So, a lot of things can go wrong unless you use the sandbox. So, you create a sandbox with 12 nodes, and then you say make a tree where the master is number one. The middle nodes are number two, three, four. So these are slaves of one and masters of 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. In the end, it will tell you that these are the nodes that are slaves of the master, and these are the nodes that are slaves of the node number two. So you have a tree. It's a little bit more complicated than that, but I'm not going to give you more details. I just want to show you one example. You can insert something in publication 3. And then run useful to see that it works everywhere, so it propagates along the tree. Checking ports in the SD tools is easy. These are all the ports and the one means that are used. If you want to see only the ones that are used, you just say you have done something very valuable in the asset and you want to preserve it, you don't want to remove it by mistake, then you use the SP tool to preserve it. Preserving means that you cannot remove this sandbox easily. Of course, if you are the owner of the machine, you can remove everything, but at least you don't remove that by mistake. So if you do clear something that you have preserved, it tells you this sandbox is permanent, so you cannot remove it. And then once you decide, okay, I'm done with this, finish the test, post value is not available anymore, unpreserved, and you're done. Delete the sandbox is very easy to understand. Roadmap, we want to do some installation on remote servers. These are top priority, and I'm going to talk to you about this shortly. Shortcuts. I'm lazy and told you. Now I decide that I can afford to be even lazy. So I have a new command that is SP. Okay. So if I call SP5136, for instance, what does it do? It will start 5136 if it's already installed. If it's not already installed, it will first install it and then start it. So I can use it as 10 keystrokes. If I want to install application for 5136, I say SP5136. And if it exists already, it will start the master. If it doesn't exist, first install it and then it calls the master. So this is a replication in 11 keystrokes. Now if this is not the master of laziness, I don't know what it is. So remote sandboxes. Who knows what German is now? No, this is not German, like somebody says. This German. German? Ever heard of it? German? Calling is qualified. My colleague knows that. It's a client side architecture, and German is actually the anagram of manager. So what does a manager do? Manager doesn't do anything. Just tells people what to do. This is the same thing that German does. So being a manager, a little bit twisted, it tells the clients and the workers what they have to do and they do. So basically there are a list of workers who advertise what they can do. Let's see an example here. So we have worker C or worker 1, and they say, I can do function 1 and function 3. And worker 2 can do function 1, function 3, and so on. So the client says, I want to do function 1, and asks this server. So this German has, I have a request for function 1. So the first worker who answers gets to work for function 1 and gives back the answer to the client. So this is the German manager, doesn't do anything but knows how to make people do things. How do I use this for sandbox? I have one client. I have one master with one worker that knows how to install the master, a sandbox. I have one different workers in a slave that know how to install and set up a slave. And in another slave, I have several workers who can do the same. So what does it do? First, it asks the master server to create a master. And it goes to remote. It asks the slave server to create a slave and the other slave. Then it asks the first slave to start the slave and this one will set up this page. It takes a few seconds more than working in local, but it works. Now, you can participate in MySQL Sandbox is an open environment. You can go to launchpad.net, MySQL Sandbox, and see the source code, the documentation, bug reports, blueprints with the roadmap, and there you can ask questions, and eventually somebody usually needs an answer. Is all the things that I want to do and that I eventually do in my spare time. Now, questions. By the way, these are stickers of Vietnam, and you are the only ones in Europe that can have this. I would not. The question is, did I use the MySQL Sandbox in production? Usually not. Although you can do it. Sandbox is being designed for testing. But if you want to use for production, you just use only one server in a host. You don't put more than that. If you need more than that, you can use the Sandbox. You have to change the password first, and you have to make the sandbox permanent. So you can do it. Personally, not do it, but it's up to you. You can do it. So you can have a sticker on the CBI. For questions, you can ask stickers. So if you want a sticker, just go here, take one, and spread the word. More questions? Yes, please. Sorry, I didn't hear anything. The sandbox is only for testing purposes, but mainly for testing purposes. But you can invent more purposes if you want. So the question is, why would you use this for production? Meaning, you need almost every operating system has a big way of installing one server. That's easy. You have Windows, just download and run the installer, and it does everything for you. You are on Linux, apt get MySQL server, or Python, apt get. Whatever, MySQL server, it does this for you. So if you want only one server, it's already done. I am late, I cannot invent anything more. But if you want more than one server, this is the sandbox. Why would you want more than one server? Usually because you want to test. The only exception would be if you want to do sandbox remote servers with gear. In this case, you can use the system for application, and you may trust the sandbox for production. Eventually, I may do that. Patches are accepted. Can anyone convert the sandbox into a virtual machine? It's already a virtual machine.
Oh, but
The question is, can a sandbox be converted into a MySQL on a MySQL server? Eventually, yes. You can just you can do it. Actually, you can think of several ways of doing that, but each way is more difficult than doing a normal server from scratch. So I don't know. I mean, you can do that for just academic satisfaction, but it's not going to do you a lot of good. Yes. So the question is, can I use remote sandboxes with VLAN, test if everything is fine, and then convert it into a real machine? There is nothing already made for that. It's a good idea for doing something different from the sandbox, and to, let's call it a MySQL deployer for instance, that may do what you say. Questions? Okay.